off the truck. They're on the floor. Go ahead and take your outer bearing out so that thing doesn't fall and get damaged. Put that off to the side. And these rotors, they're captured rotors held in by your wheel studs. And you gotta pound your studs out to get your rotors off. The options you have for getting your wheel studs out are a big hammer. You can use an air hammer. You can use a hydraulic press. They do sell stud extractors and removers. A hammer works just fine. Use a little bit of caution. I'm replacing the wheel studs, upgrading to 9/16 wheel studs over the stock half inch. But if you're not, just be mindful when you're hitting that you don't burr any of the threads over. So that's when an air hammer would work, is you can get it centered real nice. So pretty self-explanatory. Aim and hit. Once those are out, it's probably going to take a little bit of persuasion to get the hub separated from the rotor. At this point, you're changing the rotors anyways. You can just hit those, not going to hurt nothing. Just like that. And that can go in your scrap pile. So the next step after you get your rotor off, flip your hub over and you have your seal and your inner bearing in there. At this point in time, take the extra, 20 minutes, an extra couple dollars, replace your seal, and repack your bearings with grease. It's, no reason to go back and do this all over again and have a bearing go out. So you can use a seal remover like this. You can use a claw hammer. Really, whatever works. This hammer happens to work really good. I don't know why. Starts coming out, just walk it out. And trash it. Get your seals out, your inner bearing can pop out. Put that off to the side, clean everything up, inspect it, repack your bearings. So when you're cleaning your bearings up, you want to inspect them. Look for any signs of overheating, which is going to be discoloration, the metal start to turn rainbowy. Any pinning of the rollers, any cracks in your cage, any excessive play, anything like that. If there's any question whether it should be reused or not, go to your parts store and get a new bearing and a new race. It's cheap and easy insurance. And just do it right the first time. Alright, so once you get your bearings all cleaned up and repacked with grease, you can get ready to reassemble your hub. If you're not sure on how to pack bearings, there's plenty of other videos that you can go see on how to pack bearings. Take your inner bearing, all packed up, put some grease in your hub on the race, drop your bearing into place, make sure that seat's pretty square, and then take your new wheel seal. This one's from CarQuest, part number 415960. Put this in. There's gonna be two different sides. There's gonna be a smooth side of the seal, completely flat, then you're gonna have the side of the seal that's got like a little bit of an opening to it. You're gonna want that open side to go in, flat side up. Make sure that your seal surface around is clean. No grease, nothing like that. And take your seal, center it in the bore. If you have a seal installer, great. If you don't, can use a hammer, put a piece of block of wood around it. Just work it around until it's flush with the outside of the hub. And now your seal's in. All right, so grab your new rotor. You're gonna wanna drop it, not drop, place over top of your hub, and line up your holes. Now, I'm upgrading to 9/16 studs. Part number for those are 610-283. So, pretty sure these are actually a GM stud, but they share the same taper and spline design as the older Dodges do. So drop your studs in. Just like that. I found a socket on an extension works pretty good if you don't have an air hammer or access to a hydraulic press. One that kind of crowns the head of your stud works real good. And same thing with removal, you just pound them in. So just get, work in a star pattern, get them started, and then you can drive them home. All right, got the studs all pounded in. Nice and tight, no slop. Ready to go back on for assembly.
We rolling.
So take your caliper. Try to find another spot for it. Good tip is take one of your old pads, put it on the inside, and then take your C-clamp. If you don't have a C-clamp, we do have special expanders for calipers, or you just buy a C-clamp. So, the short one, the two tabs, goes on the inside. There's two slots that it goes into. You're only going to go in one way. The big one, this goes into your caliper. Just like that. Sometimes the paint, rust, everything like that, you may have to take C-clamp. Just make sure this thing gets seated on all the way. You can see the witness marks from the old brake pad. You got that. Caliper. Twist the hose. And it goes on just like that. Just like everything else. It's always a little tight with new pads on there. Bring that in, make sure it's flush up atop there. Got a good even gap. Take your lock, goes on that way. Spring clip goes over top. and trying to get that seated. And just tap it all in the place. Tap it until your hole lines up in the slot. Take the screw, locking the screw, and thread that in. And drop stuff all over the place. And snug it up.